Now we have come to know why do we need elections. We need elections to select their own government. Now they can select the person, they can select the representatives who can lead their country very well, who is educated and who can work for their welfare. And elections are the only democratic way of selecting their representatives. To choose the party whose policies will guide the government and lawmaking. See, if there is a BJP party and we have elected Narendra Modi, we have not elected only Narendra Modi, we have elected also a party who can work for us, who can make policies for us. So now in this way you can have understood very well that what are the elections, why elections are important in our country, what the benefits are citizens going to get if they select their representatives. I hope this topic is very much clear to you. Thank you very much. Now come to the point, why do we need elections? Why elections are so important in our country? So there are three questions. If we get our answers of these questions, then can we come to this point that why do we need elections? See, amazing our democracy without elections. See, in the democracy, all the perspectives of people are respected. See, if there is a direct democracy, no elections are there. See, in the last 1000 or 2000 years ago, in the France, there was a direct democracy where all the people get together, they take decisions. But now in our country, is it impossible that all the people can get together, they take decisions, then we have to take decisions from each of citizen? No, it is not impossible. It will take too much time and not all the people are so much caliber or qualified that they can take decisions for our country. So we cannot imagine a democracy without elections. Elections are very important. Second, can there be another way to select the representatives? You can see, you can say that on the basis of age or on the basis of property we can choose the representatives. See, if in our country we say that now this person is oldest in our country, we will give all the authority to this person, that this person will lead our country. But see, if that person is oldest in our country, he is on the bed, he is not in such a condition that he can lead our country. Can with this criteria work out? No. If we say now this person is very much rich and he will take out our country, then no, maybe he is not that much honest or he cannot that much qualified, he can work for our country. So if we choose, suppose if we have chosen the richest person of our country to lead our country, then would this system be called democratic? No, then there is a no chance that we can say to our country a democratic country. To avoid all these problems, we need elections. What do we need? We need elections. Good morning, students. My name is Amandeep Kaur from Akal Academy Mandir. I hope you all are very well at your homes. So today we are going to do very interesting topic. Our name of topic is why do we need elections? This is the topic from your civics. But before it, we should know that what are elections. See, our Prime Minister is elected, Chief Ministers are elected. How they are elected? They are elected through elections who represent their country. So, elections are the mechanism by which people can choose their representatives at intervals and change them whenever they want to, is called election. They choose them for their welfare, they can choose them who can make laws for them. There is a one benefit of elections, that whenever they choose their representatives and see, they think that now this party is not working for them or they are working for them very well. If their party is working or the leader to whom they have selected are working very well, then they can choose them next time also. But if they think now this party is not working them properly, they can change them. So elections are very important in our country.